Hi, my name is Don, and I'm a docent here at Point Lobos State Natural Reserve. Today, I'd like to talk to you about hermit crabs. But first, I have a question. Where in Point Lobos are we going to find hermit crabs? Do you think we'd find hermit crabs here in the Monterey Pine Forest? Well, let's see. No hermit crabs here. Do you think we'd find hermit crabs here on one of the many trails at Point Lobos? Let's take a look. No hermit crabs here. Wait, we need to go to the ocean. I bet you we'll find hermit crabs at the ocean. This is where we're gonna find hermit crabs. Weston Beach tide pools at Point Lobos. Before we go down there though, I wanna go over some safety issues. Always keep your eyes on the ocean. You never know what Mother Nature will throw at you. Could be a sneaker wave, knock you off your feet. The other issue is when you're in tide pools, you want to have sturdy rubber-soled shoes. Rocks are slippery from water and other material like plants. Also, be aware of where you're stepping in tide pools. That's where the animals and plants live, so try to step on bare rock or sand. And remember, Point Lobos is a reserve, so no collecting. Hermit crabs are crustaceans. They're usually found in the water. They have a hard outer shell and segmented legs that they walk on. I think you know of some other crustaceans. They taste good and people like to eat them. That's right, lobsters and shrimp are crustaceans. And crustaceans aren't just found in the ocean. They're found in freshwater streams and ponds too. Crayfish are crustaceans. Hermit crabs have gills that allows them to breathe water just like a fish does, and they can survive outside of water for a short amount of time as long as they keep their gills wet. Hermit crabs have what's called an exoskeleton. An exoskeleton is that hard shell we talked about earlier. It protects their body. You and I, we don't have an exoskeleton. Our bones are on the inside of our body. Hermit crabs have a problem though. Their exoskeleton doesn't cover their entire body. Their tummy and their rump are soft, and that makes them vulnerable to predators. So hermit crabs need to protect that tummy and rump, and they do that by borrowing shells, usually from turban snails. They put that soft tummy and rump inside the borrowed shell for protection. They carry that shell with them. Like you, hermit crabs grow. And like you getting older, you need new clothes. Hermit crabs are going to need a new shell. They don't take occupied shells. They only take the empty ones, but they may have to fight other hermit crabs for that shell. Hermit crabs are omnivores. Omnivores eat both plants and animals. They scavenge small, microscopic particles of dead plants and dead animals. One neat thing about hermit crabs is they have 5 pairs of legs. You and I only have 1 pair. They have 5. The first pair is modified to claws and pinchers. The second and third pair is what they walk on, and the fourth and fifth pair is what they use to hold that shell on their back. Last of all, if the hermit crab can't find a shell, it may use trash that's left on the beach, like plastic caps from water bottles. Put your garbage inside trash cans because plastic garbage doesn't make a good home for a hermit crab. Let's protect these little critters. And finally, I want to give you a challenge question. If a hermit crab has a hard outer shell, how does he grow? Thank you so much for joining me here at Point Lobos. I hope to see you in the future.